Well, showing some signs of maybe some fisticuffs in this one, and there could be more of that to come in the next 40 minutes. Chris Neal is the guy who knows what that's all about. According to hockeyfights.com, some 116 fights over his career. Brian McGrattan has maybe half that many. And according to these guys, playing the role of hockey enforcer, all about timing as we sat them down together to get them to analyze some of hockey's best fights.
Well, sometimes whenever you, for me personally, whenever we get down a goal or two and you want to get a spark for the team, that's normally when you go out and try to stir up something and get a guy to dance with you out there. But, you know, you got to do it when it's right for you, the team, not just yourself. And, you know, I think some guys are obviously different. You know, they have it set up in warm-up. I know Gratz likes chirping a couple guys in warm-up, so... He gets it rolling right off the get-go.
You learn by losing. You know, you're not going to do the same thing twice. I've been one punched, you know, two or three times. You're going to lose. Nobody wins every fight. So basically, I just learned from losing, and I won't do the same thing twice.
Any fight you go in, any given night, any other guy can, you know, come on top. But the way I look at it is the only fight you lose is the one you don't show up for. You know, anytime you're going out and sticking up for your teammates or doing whatever, if a guy ends up on top of you or you end up on top of him, you know, you're still doing your job, and you know that's half the battle.
And the fans love it.
Yeah, exactly.
He throws the hammers though, coming right over the top here. Oh. Marty can take a punch though.
Yeah, he can.
It's like all flush.
Pretty good fight back and forth.
Mind those nails though.
Yeah.
He'd be at the end of a two-minute shift and fight like that. It's awesome.
I got to watch Marty a little bit in the minors. I played with him a bit, and you know he's a tough dude out there. And you know you can't take anything away from Clark pound for pound. He's one of the toughest.
There he is.
Can't hurt Domi, that's for sure. That square head of his. He's been punched him a million times. He wouldn't have a mark on. Oh, definitely Probert had a little bit of advantage when he comes out of his jersey, which is nice, but you know, that's part of his technique. That's why he's one of the best.
A little biased, he's my favorite player ever, so I'd say he won.
Sometimes some of your best fights are your middleweights or your lightweights. You know, they just sit in there and chuck them. You know, you don't know what to expect out there, and the guys that they're fighting don't know what to expect. So, I think whenever you're going against the heavyweights, it's a different story. You know, you know what they're throwing before the game. You know, they're lefties or righties. You kind of know not to give them too much, or you know if they do get loose, you know how to protect yourself a little better. Where if you're fighting a guy that's you don't think that great of a fighter, you know, you might try to do something that you normally wouldn't do, and he'll catch you
with pop you. But my best fight I've ever had is with Josh Grattan, and he played for Phoenix a bit this year, I think. He was in Philly in the American League. It was the lockout year, and it's probably about two and a half minutes just straight toe-to-toe. You know, we almost buckled each other a couple times, used each other for balance to pull ourselves back up. But yeah, it's on YouTube. Yeah, that's probably my best fight I've ever had.
I had a great one in Boston with PJ Stock. He was a guy that just stood in there and chucked them. And you know, I think we went toe-to-toe as well, you know, just chucking back and forth. And you know, I think at the end of the fight, I still remember Andre Waugh was here, and you know, he came up and PJ Stock did his little celebration, and Andre Watt came up and lifted my hand up in the air like I got the victory, but it was a good fight.
Grim Reaper. Oh. They're two big guys too, man.
Grim Reaper.
He took one right over the eye there. Whoa.
Grim Reaper's leaking.
He's throwing hammers though.
Yeah. A pretty good tilt back and forth.
I'd say tight.
Yeah.
Because of cut. Razor's got a pretty big pumpkin, eh, Neeler?
Yes, he does. Both these guys do. Vialzova, he's got a big pumpkin too. Be a lot of punches landed here.
Like an orange on a toothpick.
Caught him one at the end.
Yeah. He's a beauty. I played with him down in Bingo there.
Oh, he was up here too. He's a beauty.
He played for 5 months. First game fights Brandon Sugden. 2 minute
first
fight.
First shift. They couldn't get their helmets off because they were wedged right on. One thing I like to try to do is get the guy's helmet off whenever you're going, and you're just kind of, you don't cut your knuckles up as bad.
Just punch it off. Well, I'd have to say LaRocque. I'd have to say Cote in Philly. You know, he's beat a lot of guys this year. He's done really well. No, I'd say Peters. I've always had good fights with him. He's a legit heavyweight. So, but I give a lot of respect to that Cote kid in Philly. I think he's going to be the next up and comer guy. So,
oh, you definitely have to say LaRocque. He's a powerful man out there. You know, it's he does very well in all his fights, and you know, you see the way I look at it, a lot of guys around the league are. You know, when you're doing that job, it's not an easy job. So anytime you're dropping the gloves with another guy, it's you know, my hat goes off to everyone out there. And you know, I think you see smart fighters. You know, like that Cote is a good fighter. You know, he just sits in there and throws. Though, you know, he's not necessarily a smart fighter, but you know, you look at I think Cole Nord's a really good fighter as well. And you know, there's so many guys that go undetected out there that you see that are really good fighters.
Squaring off, you know, he's a small guy, so I didn't want to, kind of wanted to hold him out. We got to watch because his full reach comes to my chin, so you know, I didn't want to let him pull me in tight, because, and then he's good both left and right too, so I wanted to try and hold him out as best I could, and then got the arm out and buckled him. But yeah, you got to watch with the small fighters. When they get in tight, you know, especially Ty's a really smart fighter. He fights guys my size all the time. So he, you know, he gets you spinning, gets you off balance, and that's where he lands a big bomb. So
me here, I'm trying to get a spark for the team. It was kind of mutual, so anyway, I was telling him right there to let go and started throwing. Then just trying to get loose. When I came through, I knocked his helmet off and, you know, just...
The most tiring part of the fight is that stuff.
Yeah, right? Trying to get loose.
So the wrestling and the trying to get free.
I try to duck under there to open up a bit. Trying to get the fans into it a bit, but... Then I switch up here shortly. When I come back up.
Good job.
No, it's whenever you're out there and you get the fans into it, they love this kind of stuff. So it's
10 times louder than a goal right there. Best part of the game.